Yes, friends, we are doing question number 6 here. Question 6 says that if n c n minus 6 is equal to 462, all right, and to find then value of n, what the value of n we have to find out? Because we are given here, if n c n is n minus 6, n c n minus 6 is equal to 462, try to understand. So we have to find out the value of n, because here n is unknown. So in question number 5th, we just solve r is equal to 5, that was the answer there. Because 16 r is equal to 80 and r is equal to 5, that we calculated in question number 5. Now question number 6 is, so r is equal to 5 in question number 5. Okay, r is equal to 5. Answer is 5, question number 5. Okay, so that was there. Now question number 6th here we are doing. In question number 6th, what we are given here, if n c n minus 6 is equal to 462, then find what the value of n. We have to find out this. Find the value of n, we have to solve it. We have here n c n minus 6 equal to 462. Now let me solve it. So this means factorial n divided by factorial n minus 6 into this minus this. N minus n plus 6 with minus plus is equal to 462. Why this is this? Why? Because NCR is equal to factorial n upon factorial r into factorial n minus r. This is formula of combination. Okay, this is formula for combination. Just we have to understand this point here. So in this way we have opened this. What is the formula for NCN minus 6? This we have written here, factorial n in the numerator divided by factorial n minus 6. This is difference of these two, n minus n, this is minus plus, so plus 6. This is 462. Finally, now let me further solve it. Let me solve it here. So it is factorial n upon, I'm again writing it, factorial n minus 6. Now this is n minus n cancel out, only 6 factorial. This is factorial 6 left over. This is 462. Now let me cross multiply this. And so take this numerical value to that side. And we have to open factorial n up to n minus 6. So factorial n means n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 into n minus 3 into n minus 4 into n minus 5 into n minus 6 factorial divided by factorial n minus 6. And this factorial 6 we can take to that side. That means 6 factorial into 462. This can be solved. Now factorial n minus 6, factorial n minus 6 cancelled out. Okay, in the numerator and denominator we are having the similar value, n minus 6 factorial, so that can be cancelled out. This is to be understood, because when we open factorial n, we decrease 1 continuously and write that up to 1, 2 into 1 in the end, that is factorial n means, we know about this. Okay, so that is understood to you. Now let me solve it further. Now there are how many pairs? N 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 pairs are there. Now in this factorial 6 into 462 is to be divided into 6 continuous words, letters or numerical numbers. Those numbers will be continuous numbers. They will be in continuity, right? Like for example 6 into 8 into 7 into like that. Okay, so we have to just find out what is the value of this. Now let me take this this pair, we have to pair this. This is n into, here we have solution we are finding out, n into n minus 1, n minus 2, n minus 3, n minus 4 and n minus 5 up to n minus 5 is equal to, now factorial 6 we know about 462. This is 462 into factorial 6. That means 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Factorial 6 means this. This is factorial 6. What is 462? Let me divide it. Now this is 4 plus 6, 12, 10 plus 2, 12. It can be divided by 6. Let me divide it by 6. So 6, okay. 6, 7 is 42. 42. 46 minus 42, 4. 42 again, this is 6, 7 is 42 into 6. This is 462 means 77 into 6. Into 6, into 5, into 4, into 3, into 2. Only up to 2, no problem. And 7, and this is 77, so it is 11 into 7. No problem. 6, 6 is coming 2 times, 6 into 6. Into 5, into 4, into 3, into 2. So we see here that 11 is the largest number here. 11 into 10 into 9, like that, the words must be there. This is the, I mean, just a hint of this. The hinting word is 11. 11 decreasing numbers will be there. So first is 11, let me take. Second must be 10. How 10? 5 and this 2, let me take this 5 and 2. This 5 and 2, 1 and 1, 2. So this is 10 here. Where is 9? 3 and this 6 can be written as 2 into 6. Sorry, 2 into 3. So this 1, 3 is taken here. This 3 and 3. This 2 already we have taken. 5 we have taken. This 3 and this 3, 3 and 9. This 9 here. Where is 8 now? This 4 and this 2. So this 4 has been taken, this 2 has been taken, this is 8, 4 to the 8, 7, okay, and this 6, 1, 6 is left over, this 6 has been divided into 2 into 3, trigons, and this 6 is also taken. Now this 1, 6 is left over. So this is how these 6 letters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, undoubtedly, these are the decreasing numbers, continuous numbers, decreasing numbers. So this is how this numbers, this pairs, 6 pairs of decreasing or numbers, okay, we can equate them. What we see here, n is equal to 11, simple answer. If we compare them, or n minus 1 equal to 10, n minus 2 equal to 9, n minus 3 equal to 8, n minus 4 equal to 7, n minus 5 equal to 6. Any one pair can be just compared, can be equated, and then value of n can be calculated. So n equal to, so this implies that n is equal to 11. This is the answer. So this question is finally done. Question number 6 is having answer 11. Okay, so n is equal to 11. This is the answer here. The question is completed. Let me take now question number 7. Now what is question number 7 say? First let me talk about that. Question number 7. What is given to us, but before that let me clean this. Okay, let me clean the board. It is very dark. Okay, what is the question number 7? Let me first read it and then solve it. Okay. Let us now, let me change the marker also. Okay, now question number 7. Question 7 says, what does it say? Now it says that how many numbers, it says how many numbers of 5 digits can be formed with the digits 0, 1, 2, 4, 6 and 8. So 4 digit numbers. We have to find how many numbers of 5, sorry, 5 digits. Let me take, we have the digits. We have the digits. We have the digits 0, 1, 2, 4, 6 and 8. Okay, how many digits? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 digits are there. Alright, that is one of the possibilities. Now let us take, we have to find 5 letters word. How many 5 letter words can be selected? Now it says that how many numbers of 5 digits can be formed with the digits this. So that we find. We find here how many numbers, not words, how many numbers of 5 digits. Can be formed with the digits this, or can be formed with the above digits that we have to find out. Let me find the solution of this. Solution is, now try to understand. Now here, 5 digits letters we have to find out. 5 letter words we have to find out. Now in 5 letter words, first let me just try here that first place is first place, and the unit place can be any letter, no problem. But first 5 digits, out of 5 digits, the first place can be filled in how many ways? This 0 cannot be here, otherwise 4 letter words will be there. So to frame the 5 letter words, 0 cannot come on the first letter. So this first place can be filled in how many ways? There are leftover words are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so we got total 7 words are there. Yeah, 7 letters are there. 7, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. So out of that 5 letters are left. This is 5 ways. 5P1 we can say, or this is only 5 ways. So first place can be filled in 5 ways. The remaining, let me take the words. Now first the numbers. The 5 digit numbers. Can be selected or can be arranged in how many ways? So first place, let me take first place, can be filled in 5P1. Why 5P? Because there are 6 letters. 6 letters are here. 6 digits are here. 6 digits are here. But 0 cannot come on the first place. Otherwise, only 4-digit letter will be there. Okay, so 0 cannot occupy the first place. So that can be first place can be filled in 5P1. That means 5 base. Factorial 5 upon factorial 4. 4 cancel 5 only. So 5 base. This is the first place. This 5 into the other 4 places can be filled in 5P4 way, because remaining 5 letters are there. Out of these 5 letters, 1 letter already has been selected. Now 0 can be there, so out of 6 letters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Out of 6 letters, 1 letter has been taken here, excluded. Now remaining 5 letters complete. So 5P4, this is another. Other 4 places can be filled in 5P4 ways. So total this is number of words. So this is what is that? 5 into factorial 5 divided by difference of this, only factorial 5 will be here. Because this is factorial 1 in the denominator, 5 minus 4, factorial 1. This is 5 into factorial 5. That means 5 into factorial 5 is 120. Why? Because 5 into 4, 20, 20 into 3, 60, 60 into 2, 120. 120. So, 12 5 is 60. So, 600. This is the answer here. 12 5 is 60. 600. The total answer is 600 words can be framed of this kind. Right? The 5 letters words will be 600. This is the answer here. So, question number. This one. Which question is this? 7. Question number 7 we have completed. Let us take next. Question number 8 now. What is question number 8? Let me just talk about that. What is given to us? First, let me talk about what is given to us. Here we are given. Question number 8. How many odd numbers? Try to understand. How many odd numbers, of 5 digits can be formed? How many odd numbers of 3 digits, How many odd numbers of 3 digits can be formed with the digits this? That is there. So we have here, we have the digits. We have the digits. How many digits are there? We have the 7 digits or 6 digits? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 digits are there. We have the 7 digits as 0, 1 in question number 8. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So total 7 digits are there. Right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 continuous words. Okay, no problem. So how many odd numbers of 3 digits can be formed? That is the question here. So to find how many odd numbers, try to understand odd numbers of 3 digits. This needs to be understood. Of 3 digits can be formed. Odd numbers of 3 digits can be formed. That is the question here. It says that how many odd numbers of 3 digits. How many odd numbers of 3 digits can be formed with the above. With the help of above digits. That is the question. Now try to understand the question here. Now what are the odd numbers? We know that odd numbers are when the unit place, at the unit place there are odd numbers. Now here we are having odd numbers. How many odd numbers are there? 1, 3, 5. 3 odd numbers are there. So the first unit place can be filled in, not first place, but unit place can be filled in 3 ways only. Try to understand. 3C1, or that means factorial 3, 3 only. So the first place, now out of, let me take the odd numbers. The odd numbers will have, let me write here, will have an odd number, at unit place. You know about this. How odd number? For example, 201 odd number, 303 odd number, any number. It may be 203 odd number, and 205. Let me take 205 odd number. So odd number means 1, 3, 5. So out of these 3, I mean odd numbers are 3 only, 1, 3, and 5. So in the unit place, if we put odd number, that means out of these 3 letters, so unit place can be filled in 3 ways. So the unit place can be filled in 3P1, we can say, can be filled in 3P1 or equal to 3 ways. You got difference is factorial 2, okay. So 3 ways only. So this is unit place. Let me write here unit place. 3 ways in multiplication. What about the first place? Out of the 3 letter words, the first place can be filled in. Now one letter has been occupied here. How many letters are left? Now 0 cannot come on the unit place. Try to understand. On the first place, or in the first place, this is the first place. 0 cannot come here. 0 is not here. So, one letter we have already taken here. Out of those letters, how many letters are left? Now, 0 is also excluded. Other is also excluded. 6 were there. Now, 7 letters were there. Now, 5 are left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, 5 letters are left. So, the unit place can be filled in 5P1 ways. Means 5 ways. This is 5 ways. Now, the second place or the tens place. So, hundreds place can be filled in only 5 ways. So this is 5 ways. And the remaining one place means second place or tens place, we can say. Second place or tens place. Unit place, tens place, hundreds place, 3 digit number. So tens place, this one, second place or tens place, we can say tens place, can be filled in how many ways? Now two numbers out, but 0 is still there, right? But 0 cannot come here. So out of these two letters are left. Now 0 can come in the second place, no problem. So two letters are taken out of 5, one place again, 5P1. That means again 5 base. Again 5 base, 5P1. Because one place is to be filled, second place is to be filled in 5P1. Again 5P1 base. This is equal to 5 into 5 into 3. Try to understand. So only 5 have 25, 3 have 75. So only 75 ways are there. 75. Odd numbers will be there. This is answer here. This is to be understood. Why unit place or first place cannot be filled by 0? So out of those total 6, because one letter already occupied, one letter is already there. Remaining 5 letters are left. 0 is not there. Out of 7 letters, one letter is out. Only 5 are left. So 5P1. First place is filled, mean third place. We can say the hundredth place. Hundredth place can be filled in 5P1 base. Because out of that 6, or if I take here initially, but the first we have to just that, what is the first place? I mean the unit place. Unit place must be an odd number. Odd number 3, out of 3 numbers, we have to select 3P1 base. That means 3 ways only. So this is 75 answer. Try to understand this point. This is the answer here. So only 75 is the answer here. Okay, so question number 8 computed. This is three letter word which are odd numbers can be found out of this. This is the answer, question number 8 here. Now what is question number 9? Let me talk about that. Now question number 9 is here. What is given to us? Let me first check it and then solve it. Okay, first let me clean this. Now question number 9, what did you say? Yes friends, now let me read first it. First let me read it and then solve it. So first reading it, ninth question says, how many numbers of 4 digits divisible by 5 can be formed with the digits this and this and this? Okay, so we have the words, we have the digits. How many digits are there? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 0, 1, 2, 3 and 5 letters are there. 5 digits are there. So we have the 5 digits which are, we have the 5 digits which are 0, then in the ninth question 2, 5, 6 and 9. Only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 letters are there. We have these 5 letters. Five digits are there. Then we have to find how many numbers of 4 digits divisible by 5. Okay, that is the point. Question number, to find here how many numbers divided by 5, 4 letters word or 4 letter numbers, how many 4 digit numbers, how many 4 digit numbers divisible by 5. Divisible by 5, this is very important point. Can be formed with the above five digits 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, with the above five digits we can say no problem. So this is the question to solve. Let me find the solution. Now try to understand this point. Now, which number can be divided by 5? So the unit place must be either occupied by 0 or by 5. We can say the numbers divisible by 5 are having either 5 or 0 at the unit place, at the units place, simple, at the unit place or at the units place. Okay, so unit place must be either 5 or 0. Try to understand. Now, so the first way, the two ways are there. Let me find both ways and total of them. So, first let me find when 0 is at the unit place. So that means this is only one way. 0 can be selected out of this one only in one way, that is 1. So unit place can be filled in only one way. So 1 into, what is the other, this is 4 digit number. How many 4 digit numbers? Okay, so 4 digit numbers we have to find out. So other 3 places can be filled in how many ways? Out of those 5 letters, 1 letter has been occupied here. Only 4 are left. So 4P3. Why 4P3? Because why 4P3? So this is the other 3 places can be filled in 4P3 base. 4P3, that means 4 ways only. So this is only 4 letters are there which are having here. So this is equal to 4P3 into 1. Because unit base can be occupied only in one way, because 0 is only 1. So out of this one place, 0 here can occupy only in one way because there is only 1 0. Or if I say, because other cannot be here, only 1 0 is occupied in one way. That means 1 into 4P3, that means only 4 ways. So 4 letters are there in which 0 is there. Okay, because 1, 2, 3, 4 in 0. So there are 4 letters only. Undoubtedly, so 4P3 means 4. Because factorial 4 into factorial, sorry, 4 into factorial 3 upon factorial 3. Sorry, factorial 1 only. What is this number? It will be difference of factorial 1, this is factorial 4 only. Factorial 4 into 1. Why factorial 4? Because 4P3. 3 places are to fill out of 4 letters, 4 digits. So that means 4P3. 4P3 means factorial 4 upon factorial 1. Factorial 1, 4 minus 3, factorial 1. Factorial 1 is 1, so factorial 4 is there. Factorial 4 means 24. Here 24 birds are there, numbers are there, which are having 0 at the unit place. Here the 24, this is the first part.